So in my last tutorial, I showed you how to create a silhouette portrait. This is what we created here, this big one, from a photo in Affinity Designer. Today I'm going to show you how to set up your document to turn that silhouette into a printable product that you can print yourself at home, or that you can offer to customers that they can print at home. So I no longer sell my silhouette portraits, but I brought my listing live again just so you could see what it looked like when I did sell it. And so I use shopify.com. You can sell your silhouettes on any platform at all. I offered one silhouette at $25, two for $45, three for $60, four for $75, five for $90, six for $105. And then of course you want to create beautiful mock-up photos. These are mock-ups that I created digitally. You can find photo mock-ups all over the internet. I like to purchase from other artists, so I use a lot of different mock-ups. I don't create them myself, meaning I buy the mock-ups and then insert my art into them. And then in the listing, you're going to want to include what's included and how it works. So I have a digital download that I'll show you at the end of the video. Stick around so you can see that. And that gives customers instructions on what to do after they purchase their portraits from me. I had a 5 business day turnaround when I did offer these, and I offered my portraits came with 9 PDFs and a resizable ping after you purchased it, and I'll show you those in Affinity. Now I created everything in Affinity for this listing. You can also create a silhouette of pets. So this is my sister Allie's doggy, Maggie, who has the best floppy ears in the world. And I created her silhouette and I just put it on this cute little dog cartoon background. Same exact process, same idea. With dogs, you'll want to, I'm trying to zoom in here. With dogs, you'll want to look for fun elements, like the ears are probably going to be the most important element for a lot of bigger dogs who have great ears. Maggie has these eyebrows that I also wanted to capture, and I think the jowls and the nose are also really telling. And so you want people to be able to recognize, to instantly recognize the subject of their silhouette that you've created. And once they do that, then you know that you did a great job. And so here are my 9. These are just some of the photos from the listing. These are the 9, actually I think I have 10 different backgrounds that I then sent to my customers after I created their portraits. So for each customer, these would obviously have the same silhouette in all 10 backgrounds. So there's just one general one if they want to make it just in a regular frame. They're all sized at 8x10. There's a little whimsical one, other whimsical ones, bugs. The reason I do these additional backgrounds, and I really think it's a good idea, is that it just adds extra value to your product when someone is getting 9 or 10 different things. You don't have to offer 10, that's a little bit extra. You could do 5 or 3. But what this means is if somebody buys your portrait for Mother's Day, for example, they can print one out for mom, different ones for grandma. They give you a lot of options, and I think it adds value to your product. So how do you create this background though? So here's what I do. Since these are 8x10s, I actually create 8x10 artboards. These are probably the only printables I sell that are not on regular letter size paper. And the reason is the 8x10 gives your customers a nice border for trimming it to fit into their picture frame. So if they're printing these at home, they're just gonna have to take a pair of scissors. And if this is 8x10 and they printed it actual size, it's perfectly sized, and then they can just trim the borders without any rulers to frame it themselves. So I have this 8x10 artboard. Now I'm gonna place a background. So for the background for this demo, I just found a fun watercolor background that I have access to in one of my paid subscriptions. I pay to be a member of different sites that offer huge catalogs of vectors and JPEGs and photographs for artists. So I'm just gonna place the background. So I have an 8x10 artboard and then a nice background. I eyeballed these ovals that I made as the kind of frame. So I'm just gonna copy and paste. So this oval is just under 5.5 by 8 inches. You can obviously create whatever type of oval you want. I just use my tool here and create it. The reason I copied and pasted is it's just easier to do that. This one has a little, I have two layers here, but I don't want that in my tie-dye version. I think that's a little too antiquated looking for this. I'm going to remove the exterior stroke and see how that looks. Oh, I kind of like that with these spikes sticking out. So this is all you need to do to create this oval background. And then you'll take the silhouette that you create from your photo. And remember, my trick for so you never skew your silhouette is to group it, even though it's just going to be one curve. Just group it so when you're resizing, you don't accidentally skew it. The thing I love about the oval is silhouettes traditionally were framed in oval frames. Oval frames are harder to find nowadays in just regular craft stores. And so this gives you, it's reminiscent of the silhouette's origin, but you can just put it in any 8x10 frame. So it's really easier for your end user, for your customer. So now, once you have your backgrounds, you'll see I changed the color of my silhouette to match the backgrounds. Your backgrounds should just be whatever you think are best. I always like things that are a little bit strange. So I'm going to change this silhouette. I'm just picking up my color picker tool, and I'm just trying different colors. Of course, it's set to the stroke. So let's see. That is way too bright for me. I'm going to see. I kind of want a deep purple here. Oh, I like that. I'm going to go a little bit. I want the portrait itself to be the focal point, so I'm going to go a little bit darker with that. And there, I like this a lot. The last thing that's missing is your signature. So you can create, if you look here, I just have a digital signature. I just drew this with the pen tool. And you can, it depends on how, I'm on a Mac. For some reason, I'm not a big fan of drawing with my Apple Pencil, which I thought was gonna just totally transform my digital drawing life, but it didn't. So I actually did this with on my laptop. I just pick up my pencil tool, actually not the pen tool. And then you can just, you know, draw your signature. Play around with the strokes. I'm not going to do the whole thing, but you can see you just pull it. And then, of course, you can play around with the nodes if you want to make it prettier. But that, I think you should have a signature. This is a piece of art. Whoops. I just picked up my oval. I'm just trying to delete. So I sign it. I place it somewhere. I'd probably place this more over here. So it's a little less. I don't want it to look like it's in the middle of the portrait. And so I'm going to eyeball a little. So even, you know, Affinity will snap this to the center of the oval for me. But the balance in a silhouette isn't always going to be fully symmetrical. So for example, this child's hair sticks out a little bit in the front. So if you just center his silhouette, it's going to be a little bit to the left, at least to my eye. So part of this is just eyeballing what you think looks good. So now I've placed my portrait. I have this fun background and I'm going to export it. There's so much talk about exporting as PDF versus JPEG. I think PDFs are just so much easier because they're perfectly sized. I'm going to save this as silhouette to print. And what we have here now is an 8x10 PDF. So you want to include instructions when you send your final silhouette portraits to your customer. You'll want to include instructions for them to print at actual size. So I don't want to print this on my design jet. That's a 36-inch printer. So here, you can see in my printer dialog box, the scale's at 100%, and that's what I want. If I scale this to fit, it's actually not going to skew it on mine because of my printer settings, but you never know what's going on with your customers. So you want them to print it exactly at 100%. So once you have your PDFs, you're going to send them to your customer, however it works for you in general. I also like to include a ping, a resizable ping for my customers. I make it huge. This is 17 by 23 inches. So I'm just going to export I'm going to select ping. I want the selection only. I'm just going to call it silhouette. With my customers' PDFs, I send them this ping. And so they can just place this on anything they want. I don't know what they would use it for. Some people have made stationery with their pings, but it's just nice for them to have it. So I told you at the beginning of this, I would show you what my customers receive, the automatic download, once they purchase from me. And that is right here. So it's custom silhouette portrait instructions. So I asked them, please send a clear profile photo of your child. I give them my email address. I also asked them if they want this Tiffany blue background to be a different color. Sometimes people have a nursery color they're trying to match, stuff like that. Then I just tell a little bit about the process. I'll hand draw your silhouette, digitize it, send you portraits within 5 business days. This is important for setting up expectations. What do I need from you? What will you receive from me? Here I then tell them you'll receive a PDF. I do not send JPEGs. I don't know why I had that in there. I must have sent those originally when I started this years ago. That's just a lot of work. I only send the PDFs. So this should say you'll receive PDFs of all 9 portrait designs, each featuring the same custom silhouette. So it's important that they understand they're getting one silhouette when they purchase one. All sized to fit 8x10-inch frames. You'll also receive that resizable black ping. And so this gives people information. What are the next steps? Now, if somebody purchases a portrait, a silhouette from me, and I do not hear from them within a couple business days, of course I email them and just reattach that document and say, hey, please send me your portraits. And I also ask for a need by date. Sometimes people are purchasing things and they're in a rush, but they don't tell you until the last minute. And I really need to know that ahead of time so I can plan. Of course, if someone is really looking for a rushed product, you do not have to turn things around any faster than your turnaround time. You can decline the sale or add a rush charge to it. So please drop your links below. If you're creating silhouettes, I want to see them. If you have questions, I'm here to answer them. Thanks so much for watching. Have fun creating.